It already has done that. There is concern, there is lack of visibility in the market. Banks are very concerned about their repercussions. But all of this is psychological, in my opinion, because banks, the nature of their business is to safeguard assets. So naturally, they have to plan ahead. But when you look at what Trump is saying, you have to look at what he does. He's a businessman. There was concern for us in when they were talking to Canada and Mexico, because we have sizable investment in Canada. But at the end of the day, they had an agreement and no more issue. When it comes to Europe, there was a concern, and I think they're coming to an agreement. China is a big market, United States a big market, and to Trump, he looks for fair trade versus free trade. He doesn't believe free trade treats the United States well, and that's where it comes. Since he's a businessman, I believe this whole issue between them, China and America, it's more of a, to me, is a negotiation tactic of business. They will come to an agreement. But until they come, they're disturbing the market.
Yeah. Let me ask you a very different question, if I may.
Yes.
And this is about the growth strategy for you. Now, I've seen very exciting developments about Virgin, the Hyperloop, and I've seen very exciting developments about Latin America, hence our Brazil segment just then as well. But I want to look at the region itself. Why is it, and I keep asking the same question, when I go on that strip from Abu Dhabi to Dubai, and I've been to Jebel Ali, I did interviews with one of your predecessors there, a fantastic complex. Why do we need Khalifa Ports as well? Why do we need Kizad as well? When will Abu Dhabi and Dubai stop competing and actually start working together to create this global standard infrastructure?
Actually, the nature of our market is the more facility you build, it will bring more business. In Jebel Ali, for example, Jebel Ali Free Zone is very famous, but I only have 90% of the land utilized, so I only have 10%. Kizad is giving us more facility because we don't have the land. Jebel Ali Port is reaching its maximum in capacity. We're increasing capacity with technology. So Khalifa Port is helping, because all these facilities between Dubai and Abu Dhabi, which are big portion of the business in UAE, it gives business opportunity to everybody.
And I know, so you say this is anticipating growth and future demand, but again, in so many areas, I see the two Emirates competing, anticipating that demand, whether it's in the airline sector, whether it's in the infrastructure sector, in the port sector, in attracting finance as well. I just wonder if ultimately there'll be replication that will be unnecessary, and actually whether a more joined-up strategy would really achieve a lot more.
We follow the market. And basically, everybody's going to invest as long as the market takes it. If there's no market, nobody. Government doesn't interfere. This is the policy in UAE. You want to compete, you want to do business, fine. Everybody plays on the same platform. And naturally now, if you want to do a business, invest. You deal with banks. Business is good, they're going to give you money. The banks believe it is maybe risky, they're going to give you money. The market is growing in our country, and have we listened in the past that, oh, you need only one airline, or you need less of a ports? We wouldn't be able to handle the business we handle today.